this?
So the first thing, that is the urine formation. Last we draw the, in the last lecture, we have drawn the structure of nephron, and also we have drawn the structure of the excretory system. In the excretory system, we studied that there are two kidneys, then two ureters, and that is followed by the one urinary bladder, and the last one is the urethra. The kidneys, they have the excretory unit that is called as nephron. Nephrons are responsible for the purification of the blood and hence the formation of the urine. How the different parts of this are involved and what are the various steps which is involved in the mechanism of the urine formation, that we have to do now. So there are three steps of the urine formation. What are those? Starting with the first, that is glomerular filtration. The first is, first step in this mechanism, that is called as glomerular filtration, or it is also called as ultrafiltration, or this is also called as ultrafiltration. Betterly called as glomerular filtration, but this can also be known as ultrafiltration. Now, what is this ultrafiltration or glomerular filtration? Glomerular, as the name is saying, it is, we are talking about the glomerulus part. You remember the part of the glomerulus that is in the diagram we have drawn already. If you have the diagram, you can just open that out in your notebooks. And otherwise, I'm also making a rough sketch for this. So this was the Bowman's capsule, right? The Bowman capsule in which there is the presence of glomerulus. Glomerulus is what? That is the network of the blood vessels. Okay. So this is the network of the blood vessels, the arteriole, that which enters, and that makes a huge cluster of the blood vessels within this capsule. That is, we call it as the Bowman's capsule. Right. The inner wall of the Bowman capsule is porous. Porous means that has certain pores. And having pores, it acts as a filtration membrane. ठीक है? तो pores होने की वजह से this acts as a filtration membrane. Now you can see that this membrane, that is Bowman capsule, let us say my left hand, that acts as a Bowman capsule, and my right hand, that is having the cluster of all the blood vessels in it. Okay? So this is the Bowman's capsule's membrane, inner membrane, and this is the glomerulus. So this is not fixed fully. Agar aapko ye dikh raha hai, that is, there is a gap in between. Okay? Hand jo hai, usme aur hand mein, dusre hand mein aur meri fist mein, इन दोनों में गैप है, तो पूरी तरह से ये अटैच नहीं होता है, ये गैप रखता है बीच में. व्हाई इट मेंटेन्स द गैप इन बिटवीन, व्हाई देयर इज अ सर्टेन गैप, ऐसा गैप है बीच में, क्यों है ये गैप? दैट इज बिकॉज अगर बॉमन कैप्सूल की मेम्ब्रेन और उसके ऊपर पड़ा ग्लोमेरुलस पूरी तरह से अगर उस पर फिक्स हो जाता तो पोर्स बंद हो जाते, है ना? पोर्स जो है वो बंद हो जाते अगर ग्लोमेरुलस पूरा उसके ऊपर फिक्स हो जाता, तो पोर्स बंद हो जाएंगे तो डिफ्यूजन नहीं होगा, फिल्ट्रेशन मेम्ब्रेन की तरह ये एक्ट नहीं करेगा, दिस विल नॉट हेल्प इन प्योरिफिकेशन ऑफ द ब्लड एनी मोर. सो दैट इज व्हाई द नेचर हैज मेड इट जस्ट थोड़ा सा गैप छोड़ के थोड़ा ऊपर रखा है. बॉमेन कैप्सूल की मेम्ब्रेन के साथ बिल्कुल अटैच नहीं है ग्लोमेरुलस, थोड़ा ऊपर है, ठीक है, ताकि फ्रीली जो इम्प्योरिटीज हैं ब्लड की, यहाँ पे ब्लड फ्लो कर रहा है, तो जो इम्प्योरिटीज हैं ब्लड की वो फ्रीली एंटर कर जाए टूवर्ड्स दिस Bowman's capsule. ठीक है, जो फिल्ट्रेशन होती रहेगी इजिली, एंड हेंस हमारा ब्लड जो है वो प्योरीफाई होता रहेगा इजिली. ठीक है, सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट स्टेप, दैट ऑफ ग्लोमेरुलर फिल्ट्रेशन. दिस फिल्ट्रेशन, दैट इज द ब्लड ऑफ द ग्लोमेरुलस इज फिल्टर्ड आउट एंड ऑल द इम्प्योरिटीज आर गिवन आउट इन टू द Bowman's capsule. विद द हेल्प ऑफ अ मेम्ब्रेन विच इज द मेम्ब्रेन ऑफ द ग्लोमेरुलस. ठीक है, दैट इज द पोर्स ऑफ द ग्लोमेरुलस दैट हेल्प्स इन दिस पर्टिकुलर एक्टिविटी. गॉट इट? राइट. हियर व्हाट एवर इज बीइंग फिल्टर्ड आउट इज द थिंग दैट व्हिच इज हैविंग द मोर और द एक्सेस ऑफ इट और द हाई कंसेंट्रेशन ऑफ इट. ब्लड के अंदर जिस चीज की हाई कंसेंट्रेशन है वो अपनी हाई कंसेंट्रेशन से Bowman कैप्सूल की तरफ, लो कंसेंट्रेशन की तरफ आगे चला जाए. ऐसे ही है, ब्लड आते जा रहा है यहाँ पे, अंदर जाएगा, जितना हाई कंसेंट्रेशन पे सॉल्ट से हम निकलते जाएंगे, एंड हेंस जितना निकाल दिया सॉल्ट, दैट इज ओके, एंड वापस बाकी सारा आर्टरी वाला ही ब्लड आगे, इम्प्योरिटीज वाला ही ब्लड आगे भी चलता जाएगा इनटू द नेक्स्ट
efferent artery. ठीक है.
After the Bowman capsule, there is the PCT. We drew, we have also drawn this particular part. That is the PCT, right? What makes an entry here? That is from the blood. There is water and certain salts, or we can also call them as the solutes which were dissolved in the water, or the water and the solutes all present as impurities in the blood. ठीक है. So क्या क्या यहाँ पे filter out हो रहा है? That is the water, which is the used water or the excess water, that will be filtered out along with some of the solutes. Solutes can be in the form of the salts. हम जिसको simple language में salt भी कह सकते हैं. So this is the solutes which are smaller than the protein sizes, the proteins which are required by our body. Okay. So these things are all filtered out. Why do we call this as ultrafiltration? This is because of the microscopic size, very minute size of these pores. When the pores are very minute ones, बहुत छोटे-छोटे pores हैं, उसकी वजह से हम इसको ultra size के pores हैं, ठीक है? Ultra size pores हैं, very minute they are. So that is why we also call this as ultra filtration. Okay. So this was the first step, that is the glomerular filtration, in which the inner membrane of the Bowman capsule that acts as the filtration membrane. The blood's impurities goes through, or they passes across the wall of the capillary, that is the wall of this, we can say, blood vessel. Then it passes through the gap, secondly, the gap hai beech mein. And third is, it passes through this inner membrane of the Bowman's capsule. So Bowman capsule ki jo inner membrane hai, uske mein se hota hua ye aage chala jayega. अब आगे जब गया विद इन दिस पार्ट दैट इज द पीसीटी पार्ट है ना, तो यहाँ पे सबसे पहले मैक्सिमम वाटर और सॉल्यूट्स रिलीज आउट हो रहे हैं, दैट इज दे आर कमिंग आउट फिल्टर्ड आउट फ्रॉम द ब्लड एंड दे आर एंटरिंग, दे आर मेकिंग इट्स एंट्री टू दिस पार्ट ऑफ द नेफ्रॉन दैट इज द पीसीटी पार्ट, राइट. इन दिस पीसीटी देयर विल बी वाटर अलोंग विद द सॉल्ट्स इन हाई कंसंट्रेशंस दैट व्हिच हैव बीन फिल्टर्ड एंड दैट added salts to this water gives the urine the yellowish coloration. ठीक है, जो yellow coloration है urine का, that is because of the addition of the salts in the water. Clear? But there is also one factor that we studied earlier also, and that was that there is, for a normal kidney, there is 180 liters per day's urine formation. That is the purification of the blood which is doing, which is taking place in a day, is 180 liters. But we are not urinating out that much amount, we are only urinating out only the 1% of it, hai na. So we are urinating out only 1% of it, means we are removing out only 1% of the urine which has been prepared by us in a whole day, by our kidneys in a whole day. After this, where does this 99% goes? Where does this 99% goes? The 99% that which is not urinated out of the body, ye urinated out hai, ye urine prepared hai by the kidneys, okay, for a day, by the normal kidneys, okay. So where does this 99% goes? The 99% is reabsorbed, that is back into the blood, it re-enters, okay. So that which makes the second step of this phenomena, that is reabsorption. This is reabsorption. The 99% which could not make its entry out of the kidney, and that is through the urinary bladder, jo nahi ja pai urine, aur jisko hum log urinate out nahi kar payenge for a day in a normal manner, so that is all reabsorbed back by the blood vessels. Now this reabsorption, that should be kept in the mind, it is for what? That is the reabsorption is for the blood vessel. Blood vessel ne reabsorb kar lena hai, blood vessel ko wapas phir se cheez milti ja rahi hai, and it is getting the salts which can't be given out, they are getting it back. Okay, the reabsorption is the reabsorption made by the blood vessels. Okay, so what all materials are reabsorbed here? That is the materials like water. If there is some water which was not initially used, but because of the high and the low concentrations, it went out of the blood. that will not be thrown out, that will be reabsorbed. Also, glucose like solutes, which are very important in our body. The glucose molecules, until and unless the last molecule of it is not consumed, that is not utilized, you can say, by the body, it will not be discarded out. Similarly, the other amino acids are there, that which will not be given out if they are not priorly utilized by the body. Also, some of the required or the very important kind of the ions, okay, jo required or the needed ions, we can say, that will not be thrown out of the body. They will be all reabsorbed back into the blood vessels. So they are all coming back, they are re-entering into the blood vessels. We made a network there. आपको याद है हमने यहाँ पे पूरा नेटवर्क बनाया था इसका इस तरह से. That is showing all the branches of this, है ना? So that is the network is all around the renal tubules of this nephron. So it makes its re-entry back into the blood. Okay, that is reabsorption. Now in case the whole of the nephrons, this is after this there is the U-shaped structure, that of the loop of Henle. Then there is the DCT, है ना? Then finally, there is a collecting duct. Aisa structure tha, I'm just making the rough of it. So this is the blood vessels. They are all coiled around this and there is maximum coiling so that the maximum reabsorption can take place. But if in case there are some of the ions which are still not being reabsorbed by the blood, what will happen? The later parts of this tubule, that is a renal tubule, the later parts of the renal tubule will give it out, will provide it out, that is they will be secreting it out into the blood. Wo khud se secretion kar denge, andar se bahar nikal denge, that is the secretion from the renal tubules takes place, and that is why we call this as a tubular secretion as the third step. So this is the third step in the urine formation, that is tubular secretion. The secretion for all those ions, for all those electrolytes, for all those components that which are required by the body and which should not be thrown out from the body in the form of the urine, that are all secreted back into the blood vessels by the renal tubules. Okay, so what all components are thrown out or secreted out by the renal components? That is the hydrogen ions, potassium ions, some of the useful drugs, drugs means the medicines that you are taking, and the nitrogenous compounds such as creatinine, etc. Nitrogen compounds like creatinine, etc., they are being secreted by the renal tubules back into the blood vessels. Clear? They are removed by the secreted by the renal tubules back into the later parts of the renal tubules, again back into the blood, so that this concentration is approximately achieved. That is, only 1% should be urinated out, not 99%. That 99% is reabsorbed back. Okay, so this was the mechanism of the urine formation. Yes, Amritpal, just a minute. Before that, next is the hemodialysis topic. Before this hemodialysis, there is, what is the need for this hemodialysis? Why this hemodialysis is required? Hemodialysis, or simply the dialysis, that is required properly when the kidneys, they are not functioning in a normal way. We told you that in a normal kidney, this is the amount of the urine which is being prepared, and this is the amount of the urine which is urinated out in a day. So this is when the kidneys, they are functioning in a normal sense, that is normal healthy kidneys and a healthy organ we are having, and they are working in a healthy manner. But what if there are some of the problems which are given to this because of some factors? The problems are arising in the body, they are provided to some of the organs, and some special organs they get infected. What can be the reasons that the kidneys get infected? The two major reasons, and you can say the two major causes, that is the two common causes for the kidney failures, or we also call kidney failure as renal failure. So the two main causes for the kidney failure or the renal failure are number one factor that which affects the kidneys, that is the age.
Age is a factor.
Because of the age, that is when there is declination of the age, we say, the more will be the age of a person, there will be more of the declination in the functioning of the organs. Actually, there is in our life span, we say, in a normal lifespan, in a normal, like in a healthy and a normal lifespan, every human being has to face some of the changes. This you know not to draw this, okay? You may sirf aapko samjha rahi hu. ये ड्रॉइंग है ना, ये हमारा लाइफ स्पैन का एक ग्राफ है. ग्राफ क्या होता है? दैट इज फ्रॉम बर्थ टू डेथ, राइट? एवरी ह्यूमन पर्सन हैज टू गो अक्रॉस सेवरल ऑफ द चेंजेस एंड दैट चेंजेस विल बी लाइक दिस. दैट विल बी द चेंजेस व्हिच आर सीन इन द फॉर्म ऑफ दिस ग्राफ, है ना? फर्स्ट इट इज राइजिंग राइजिंग, देन अ कॉन्स्टेंट फेज एंड देन अ डिक्लाइनेशन फेज. दैट इज हाउ अवर बॉडी वर्क्स फ्रॉम बर्थ टू डेथ, राइट? After the birth, there is an infant phase, then there is a kid phase, after that there is adolescent phase, okay? Adolescent phase mein reproductive system ki maturity aati hai, phir uske baad there is a maturity phase. Maturity phase is the constant phase that stays for some time in the human beings. After that, after maturity, that is on an average, the age of the humans, that is 45 years of the age, they are known to be mature people, right? After that, there comes the declination. Declination means now the graph has to fall down. There is a stage in our lifespan, we call it as aging. Then there is senescence. Senescence kya hota hai? Jab hamare organs maturity ke baad aging ki taraf jaate hain, to hamare organs mein kuch problems aani shuru ho jati hai, hai na? Normal bodies ke liye, normal humans ke liye, to yahan pe kuch problems jo hain wo yahan pe aani shuru ho jati hain, that is because of the age. When this is like a small problem, then it is aging. And when the problems enhance again, that is senescence. आप लोगों ने देखा होगा कुछ बड़े बुजुर्ग लोग होते हैं जिनको सुनाई नहीं देता, बिल्कुल ही सुनना बंद हो जाता है. पहले तो सुनाई ऊंचा देता है, फिर बंद हो जाता है, यहाँ दिखाई नहीं देता. तो दैट इज देयर ऑर्गन ईयर्स, है ना, जो हेयरिंग एड है. तो हेयरिंग के लिए जो ऑर्गन है हमारा, वहां पे प्रॉपर स्टॉपेज आ जाता है किसी फंक्शनिंग का. तो दैट इज senescence. So for aging, while this aging stage is going, like हमारा phase of the life cycle चल रहा है, उस समय में maximum organs के ऊपर जो functioning का load है वो बढ़ना शुरू हो जाता है, and hence उनका काम जो है वो कम होना शुरू हो जाता है. Full stoppage अगर कहीं कहीं आ जाए तो वो ये वाला phase है, और बिल्कुल ही पूरी body stop हो जाए function करने पे तो that is the death, है ना? So that is a normal lifespan in a human's life. Okay, so this is also one of the factors, age. Because of the aging, the organs, they get disturbed, their functioning gets disturbed, and the most, you can say, common type of the organ that which is because of the aging is infected, that is the kidneys. Okay, the kidneys, they are mostly infected because of the age. That can be one factor. Due to the age, this may lead to the misfunctioning of the organs, and hence the kidneys may get damaged. May get, I'm not saying in all the humans it has to damage, okay, they may get damaged, right? Another factor that which leads to the kidney failure is the poor habits. The poor habits, like that of the eating habits, the poor habits can be taking up of the drugs and all, right? So that are the poor habits, the poor habits of eating food. Like if we say we are not taking up the salad or something boiled in our diet, we are only taking the junk food. We are always eating the breads and all those things that which can't be easily digested in our body system. So that puts a load on your body system. And you are having the poor habits like that of the taking more of the alcohol. That is excess of everything is bad, right? Taking more of the alcohol, then the smokers, the cigarette smokers are there. They are having the poor habits. Then thirdly, there can be the tobacco chewers. Okay. So these are all poor habits. If this is also ह्यूमन के साथ कंसर्न है, तो ऑब्वियसली दैट इज ऑल्सो गोइंग टू इफेक्ट द ऑर्गन, एंड द मोस्ट डेलिकेट ऑर्गन विच विल बी इन्फेक्टेड मोस्ट प्रायरली, दैट विल बी द किडनी जोन. ओके, सो दीज आर द सम ऑफ द कॉमन टाइप ऑफ द फैक्टर्स दैट विच लीड्स टू द किडनी फेलियर और रीनल. बट इफ एनी ऑफ दीज फैक्टर्स आर एक्टिंग ऑन the kidneys and they are leading to their failure, what can be the treatment methods?
The one method, that is the hemodialysis, that is
the very first method, dialysis. We simply call it as dialysis, or we also call it as hemodialysis. Hemo means blood. We are signifying the dialysis of blood, hemodialysis. Okay. And the second is transplantation. If there is a huge damage to the kidneys, right? The kidney is not functioning, like 90-95% of the kidney is not functioning. It is purely damaged. It is properly damaged. There is no scope of it to be getting renewed and working it properly again. Then what is there? The doctors, they suggest the transplantation. That is, the kidney will be removed from a body, from the body of a person, and taking the kidney from some other donor, matlab kisi aur human person se hi liya jayega, taking the kidney from some other donor, that will be fitted into this patient's body. That is what we call it as transplantation, provided that blood group should be same, and also there should be no poor habits to the donor person. Donor person jo hai, unki bhi koi habits aise poor nahi honi chahiye, healthy kidney hona chahiye. अब आपके माइंड में क्वेश्चन होगा कि अगर हम किसी पर्सन से ही लेके पर्सन को देंगे तो वहां इफेक्ट आएगा. जो एक नॉर्मल कंडीशन है बेटा, कई ह्यूमन बॉडीज ऐसी भी होती हैं जिनमें सिंगल किडनी होता है बाय बर्थ एंड दे आर वर्किंग प्रॉपरली. सो इफ हैविंग टू किडनीज दैट इज ऑल्सो ओके, इफ हैविंग वन किडनी दैट इज ऑल्सो ओके, योर बॉडी विल फंक्शन अकॉर्डिंगली. ठीक है, सो द डोनर पर्सन कैन गिव वन किडनी टू द पर्सन, प्रोवाइडेड अगर उनकी दूसरी किडनी जो है वो प्रॉपर 100% हेल्दी एंड फंक्शनिंग. ठीक है, और ये जो रिसिपियंट होंगे जिनको आप ट्रांसप्लांट कर रहे हैं उनके केस में दिस विल बी टोटल डैमेज विल बी देयर टू द बोथ द किडनीज एंड देयर इज नो पर्टिकुलर स्कोप कि वहां पे वो सही भी हो सकती है बिल्कुल. ठीक है, देन ओनली द ट्रांसप्लांटेशन इज रिकमेंडेड बाय द डॉक्टर्स. ओके, यस ध्रुव मेहता, यू हैव अ क्वेश्चन. कंसेप्ट ऑफ द ट्रांसप्लांटेशन and dialysis or hemodialysis, this is a topic from your NCERT books one box. Okay, it's not a text type of the content, but it is given an extra knowledge type of a content in your box. So you are to do this, right? We will be doing it tomorrow in the class. With the diagram we will be explaining the dialysis or hemodialysis concept. Okay, so any questions further anybody having?